Welcome. In this video, we'll learn to use a Kyle LaTeX editor. Similar to TechStudio, this is another good LaTeX editor which we can use. You can download from the internet. Just go to Google and type Kyle LaTeX editor for Windows. Open the first link. Go to download. You can use any of the given options. I'll use a second one. Save this. Downloading is completed. Before installing Kyle, make sure that you have already installed a LaTeX distribution. For Windows, you can use a Miktex distribution. You can check whether it is installed or not in your system. Just open a command prompt. Type LaTeX blank space double hyphen and version. Press enter. This is 2.9.7029 version. If it is not installed in your system, then you can download from the internet. It's completely free, and then you can install this. After installing Miktex distribution, you can install Kyle LaTeX editor. Next, next. This is the default path. No need to change. We can put this at the desktop. Just drag this. Now open this. In left panel we can view source file, and in the right panel we can view the output. We can easily create a new file using this option. If you have already source files, you can directly open using this option, or directly we can use a drag and drop option. This is the main text file. Right side we can see the output. We can compile PDF LaTeX. Just press here. Similarly, we can compile BibTeX. Then again PDF LaTeX twice, and then view PDF. In the message box, it is asking to disable the preview option. For viewing the output, just go to settings, then live preview. Rather than using disable option, we can use auto compilation. Whenever we make some changes in the source file, our output will be automatically updated. We can also use a quick build option. If you are not able to see this option, then just press at down triangle and select quick build. Then go to settings, build, quick build. Choose BibTeX. Similarly, PDF LaTeX twice. Change the order. Press at OK. Remember, if you want to use a quick build, then you will have to disable the preview. So it's very simple, and you can use this editor. That's all. Thanks for watching.